As an architecture student, my friends and family would often ask me why new buildings look so cold, sterile, and just plain bad compared to old buildings. I used to tell them that they were simply romanticizing history, or they didn't understand the modern theory and functionality of contemporary architecture. Admittedly, that's a pretty elitist response I gave them. But after years of living and working in downtown Toronto, where new projects are going up all the time, I started to wonder that maybe my friends are right. Maybe, quite simply, historic architecture is better. So then, how do we go from this to this? And why does that matter? On the left, we see the prominent use of ornament that brings the building to the human scale by breaking up big wall surfaces into smaller and more detailed pieces. It creates these complex rhythms and hierarchies that draws your eye across the building. And it acts like a visual language, where repeated symbols and patterns gain cultural meaning within a region. And the fact that ornament has been seen across all sorts of cultures, regardless of geography, era, or class, suggests that it's actually an innate human desire. Now, compare this with the building on the right, which is just a simple and expressionless glass monolith and offers no visual interest to the public. What my research tries to understand is why ornament has seemingly been lost to history. Now, I could bore you with a century's worth of modernist or Bauhaus architecture theory, but I'm more interested in the economics of it. Or in other words, what sort of corporate values changed that turned bank buildings from looking like that to this? The simple answer is neoliberalism, which is a set of ideas about free market capitalism, globalization, and shareholder primacy that currently dictates the economy. But this is the same economy that has produced the massive wealth inequality and the elitism that populist movements are now protesting. And movements like Brexit shows the anger that people have towards globalization, which has produced cities and buildings that no longer reflect any local culture. So, in understanding buildings as the product of economy, my research seeks to study the history of capitalism and architecture to better understand how to meet the public's natural human desire for ornament. Thank you.